And here on the Central Coast, a number of local firefighters are joining in on the battle. Among them, a Salinas battalion chief who's leading a team made up of, in part, other Monterey County firefighters. With more on their assignment, here's Action News reporter Tom Miller, who joins us live in Salinas. Tom.
Brittany, it's here at Fire Station 1 and at structure fires throughout this city that we're used to seeing Battalion Chief Brett Loomis, but today he's 150 miles away in the fight against an inferno unlike anything he's ever seen in this city.
It's a very, very different element. We're talking about a timber fire here, which is very, very dynamic and fast-moving, but we go through extensive training. There's mandated training that every firefighter here has to go through before they can even touch a wildland fire.
Near the fire line at what's become one of the largest blazes in state history, Salinas Fire Chief Brett Loomis says by phone that his team arrived early Thursday morning and has been working almost nonstop since.
That day starts between 4:30 and 5 a.m. And then we get out to the line after briefing by 8, and we happen to be here on the line until almost 9:30 or quarter to 10 last night, and then it's an hour travel time back to the base. Then it's the firefighters putting their apparatus back in service. So, you know, essentially the firefighters yesterday put in nearly 20 hours. So, and we were up doing it again this morning because that's what we do.
Loomis is leading a strike team made up of 5 engine companies. 3 are from the Bay Area. 1 is from Monterey County. The other is based here in the city of Monterey.
The team's first day was dedicated to protecting the Pine Mountain Lake community in Tuolumne County. Now they're working to put a fire line around the Hetch Hetchy Reservoir, all the while defending the gem that is Yosemite National Park.
So we're helping to protect the resources that people from all over the world come to see, you know, in California yearly. So the exhaustion that sometimes we experience is worth it.
If needed, the team is cleared to stay up there for 2 weeks straight. If they're needed for even more time, then they'll have to receive additional clearance from their respective departments in order to get that extra time. Brittany?
All right, Tom, thank you so much. Now, it is important to note that none of the strike team's firefighters' regular districts are suffering personnel shortages because of this rim fire. Daily staffing levels are still being met.